evening and welcome to Blackburn Cathedral on this beautiful day for a programme of what promises to be some very beautiful music. We're incredibly grateful to Nigel Spooner for stepping in at the last moment for Michael Payne, who unfortunately is not able to be with us today. But when people step in at the last moment, it's never a case of it being second best. It's always instead something of an unexpected treat, and I know that is going to be the case with Nigel. Can I draw to your attention some of the forthcoming events which you should be able to see on the back of your programme? Next week we have Dominic Eatwell's
This programme, I know John has very generously provided some programme that's so great that I didn't have to do it. And I will briefly just say a little bit about the programme and then we can enjoy the music. Let's hope. I first heard that piece actually in Notre Dame, opening a recital by an organist from Sydney, whose name I can't remember, even if I didn't know it in the first place. But it was electrifying, in fact. It was on the full Notre Dame, with all its horizontal reeds. I think he blew everybody out of their seats. So I thought I'd try and follow his example. He wrote that, in fact, in 1946, so it has this sort of feeling of, as you can imagine, the French in particular, of the conclusion of the Second World War. Langlais got the organist skills that he wanted, and also this sort of has a bit of a novelist programme towards Easter, rather framed by two giants of the French organist world at the beginning and the end. So a very frenetic sort of piece, but suddenly at last finds an E major chord that is quite satisfied with at the end. I know Michael Payne very well. We once went on an open tour through Holland in 1982. Can you imagine them together on what was really an open tour, but a very nice open tour for a week in Holland with other people as well. And I know he's very, very sad that he can't be here today and is very much looking forward to it. So I've mentioned that there is some Easter tilt of the programme and some also Mothering Sunday. Those who are finding Lent a bit much to cope with, will then hear something of what comes towards the end of it. The next piece by Jeanne, Demessieux, has been much this year on promoting more of the music of female organists and quite like so. And Jeanne Demessieux was somebody with a phenomenal technique and actually phenomenal memory of the number of pieces that she could play. This is on an Easter playing song. Melody, and I think you'll enjoy what she's done with it. After that, there's a bit of a sorbet. I don't know what they would call it. It's a bit of loose moosh, but it's too late for that. So a bit of froth from Nigel, Ogden, no stranger to these parts, and well known for being on the organist entertainers for many, many years in the program, which is sadly now no more. So. This makes use in this organ a lot of pitches which are not the fundamental pitch or one octave higher still, but somewhere intermediate. They don't vary in the fixed, certainly intermediate pitch, so fifths or thirds or other intervals. What some people will call mutations, but perhaps in COVID scenarios, mutation is the sort of word we like to mention these days. So, but there's quite a nice alternative, which is fractions. So you could hear the fraction stops. And after that, she was a piece with very strong memories for me because I first heard this played by John Winter, who was my first teacher at Truro Cathedral. In the sense that he was my first teacher, not one of the first of many teachers I managed to get through because they soon moved on to somebody else. I struggled to find this piece for a long time. I'm very grateful to Nigel Gaze, another London organist. When I was searching for this, and might have put in variations on ground bass. It's actually called Introduction and Variations on Ground Bass. And you know, when I googled that, straight away it came up from some obscure supplier of secondhand music. And I would always think of that sound of the Truro, especially towards the end, where he harmonises the ground bass actually with the tune at the top. Wonderful harmonies and a lovely slide into the last cadence. Has got the most massive 16-foot reed on the pedal, which is always at its best when it's in contrary motion with the tune at the top and sends shivers down the spine. I can feel it now. Kai Baylor wrote an enormous amount of music. Was very taken actually with cymbal sounds as well. A great exploit of the colour of the organ as you'll hear. And he deleted the E's from it because of what was happening with the rise of Nazism in Germany at the time and moved to France and decided it was better that he didn't have an them seek fruit with ease and into the sort of Wagner connections and the relationship that announces it's true. Another memory piece, which is a little sentimental for me, is that this Gerufle Scherzo, a long time ago now, I was a finalist in the international organ competition at St Albans. And a lot of us wrote, I won't mention the name of the piece, but a lot of us ran our way through a piece which we were greatly tempted to, only to find that an alternative piece we could have chosen was the Gerufle Scherzo. Absolutely delightful piece. And then last of all, the great Marcel Dupré, who succeeded Vidor at Sanson Peace, great open temple, only in Paris for us organists. And these were first written in, I think, 1914. But Vidor, even Vidor protested about that on some atom difficulties. So those are two words which I always remember as a bit of a disclaimer at the beginning, if you like, to mention these names. And it was only as a result of Dupré giving complete recitals, the first person to do actually, of all of Bach's words from memory. Only after that, in 1921, that a publisher decided, it's adequate, so he might be quite famous, perhaps we'll publish them. And he wrote this really for